Welcome back. Well, she's been described as having the finest vocals in Australian music, and after her breakthrough hit, Kate Miller-Heidke became a household name. And caught up with her yesterday.
Kate's expansive and diverse career has earned her ARIA nominations in a range of categories like Single of the Year, Best Contemporary Album, Best Classical Album, and even Best Comedy Release. In the last few years, the pop erratic singer-songwriter has turned her considerable gifts to musicals, operas, and of course, Eurovision. Well, now Kate is back on the road, kicking off her highly anticipated Australian tour, and she joins me now. How are you?
I'm really well, Ange, thanks.
Now, your voice has been described as the best in the biz, quite accurately, if I might add, and that listening to it is like making love with butterflies. Is that what audiences are in for on this tour?
Oh, look, I don't know about that. That's very kind of you to say. I think the quote was, it's like being made love to by butterflies.
That sounds better.
To me, it's quite a vivid image. That was the Neil Gaiman who said that. But, yeah, I really like that that visceral image.
I suppose we've got to ask... Are you bringing the stilt singing into the mix, or have they been retired since Eurovision?
Look, the stilts will live to see another day. Unfortunately, they're really bloody heavy and we can't fit them in our suitcases for this tour. So I'm going to have my feet firmly on the ground this time, which will be a relief.
You recently shared a new version of You Can't Hurt Me Anymore with Jaguar Jones. How did that powerful collab come about?
We actually met at a songwriting camp, an APRA Song Hubs, and we were just having coffee and chatting one morning before we went into our sessions. And she opened up and told me about a whole bunch of, you know, awful things that happened to her during her childhood. And just at that moment, I felt really connected with her, and it brought back some memories of some things that I'd been through too. And, yeah, so that conversation was at the forefront of my mind that day during the writing session. And it's, yeah, when I wrote this song called You Can't Hurt Me Anymore. And it's about dancing on the grave of an abuser, basically. And so, yeah, down the track it really made sense to invite her to be part of it. And I love what she brought to the track. You know, she's got this incredible voice and presence and this sort of rich groundedness about her that she brought something totally new to the song.
What you talk about there is proof to me of the healing power of music. Is that something you believe in?
Yeah, I do, you know, and I live it and I need it. I only sort of fully recognised how much I rely on it when the pandemic hit and, you know, we were all deprived of that chance to get together, to congregate and hear music. There's something about the power of live music which I think is truly healing, and this tour has been such a long time coming, and that's, you know, partly why I'm looking forward to it so much, just to be together with people again. You know, it's something that I just, yeah, I need.
Yeah, and we as audiences do too, let me tell you. Besides touring our Aussie shores, you're the only person to have sung at Coachella, Met Opera and Eurovision. So which was the most nerve-wracking or exciting?
I mean, look, they were all amazing, but in terms of nerves, just the idea of performing live to 300 million people, having to sing a stupid high note, which I stupidly put into the song, and then I had to bloody sing it every night, and then having to climb up, you know, a 7 metre high bendy pole that swayed more and more from side to side as I got up to the top, and then looking down and strapping myself in. All of those things combined made the Eurovision performance. I mean, it was, I moved to a plane beyond nerves. I was just outside of my body. Yeah.
Amazing. Self-inflicted, I might add, but amazing.
Yeah, totally. That made it worse.
In 2020, you covered Kate Bush's hit Wuthering Heights during Sydney's New Year's Eve celebrations. Is there a possibility we could see you covering Running Up That Hill since it's been shooting up the charts?
Look, quite a few people have been requesting Wuthering Heights, actually, for this tour. And, you know, once upon a time I would have said no. There's just always been something I've resisted about that song and Kate Bush, obviously. But I think I'm getting pretty tempted now. Yeah, either Running Up That Hill or possibly Wuthering Heights, I think could be a goer.
Oh, this is a tour I do not want to miss, and you don't want to miss it either. Kate Miller-Heidke's Child in Reverse tour kicks off on July the 6th, and you can head to frontiertouring.com for ticket info right now. Kate, lovely to catch up with you, and it will be great to see you back out on the road.
You too. Thanks so much, Ange.